Hi, this is Mike Sayers from Mechanical Simulation. This is a short instructional about the run control screen, which is the first thing you see when you launch a product like CarSim, TruckSim, BikeSim, or Suspension Sim. This video is intended for new users of our software. When you first look at the screen, you look at the title, and it has three pieces of information up here. What is the database name that you're in, CarSim Data? What is the library that you're in, CarSim Run Control? And what data set are you looking at? And that would be the quick start guide example. Now let's say we're somewhere else. For example, I'm looking at a vehicle screen here. I'm not in run control, and obviously the data set's wrong. We call it the home screen because I can click the home button up here, and that takes me back to the run control. I'm not looking at the data set that I want, so I go to the data set menu, and this gives a list of every data set that is in this library. The quick start guide example baseline happens to be the first one, so we'll return by making that selection. Now the screen is divided into three regions. On the left is where we set up the simulation by choosing a vehicle, a test procedure, and possibly other kinds of information. In the middle are buttons to run the simulation and some settings to control how that run is made. And on the right side are buttons that let us look at results. We have video, video plus plot, and plot. When we click the video plus plot, we see the results of this existing simulation with a animation from a video camera and plots. Now we have another video that goes through the basics of this tool, which is called the VS Visualizer, so we won't go into much detail here. Notice that everything is dimmed except for the three buttons that are available to go to the visualizer and some stuff below. The reason is that this data set is locked. If I click the button, it's unlocked, and now I can make changes. But when you're starting out with the software, you don't want to do that. Leave things the way they are, and when you make new runs, you'll use new data sets for that purpose. For example, we'll make a run. Up here is a button that says duplicate. And this is the way that we operate a lot in these software packages. You take an existing data set, duplicate it, and then you can make changes. Now that we're in a copy, it's not locked anymore. We've got checkboxes that work. We don't have buttons to look at results because we haven't run the simulation yet. So with the checkboxes, we can always right-click to get information about them. We have this box checked that is showing an option up here to show a preview point in the animation. We have another one down here that will show some more controls. We choose that. For the controls, we've got a lot of options here for speed. We'll choose the constant target speed. Our previous run was at 120 kilometers per hour. We'll make this one really slow. Choose 50. To make the run, we just go up here at this run button, click it, and the run is done. Now we can look at the results from this by the same button that we had before. We do have the speed as a variable being plotted, and we can see real easily that it's going at 50 kilometers per hour as we specified. Now what if we want to see plots from this run compared with the original? We change the color up here. Red is fine. We check the box down here to say overlay videos, and here is a configurable link to other data sets in this library. We'll go back to the original baseline, and now when we go to video plus plot, we see two vehicles. It's not very exciting because the speed is so different, but we will see later on in other examples that this can be very good for looking at subtle differences between the simulation runs. Now just a few more things to look at that we can get access from the run control screen. Down at the very bottom is a button that says view, and we have an options of things that we can view. This is an echo file which is written at the very beginning of the run, and it has all the parameters and tables that were used to make that run. This is the complete documentation of the conditions that were used for the simulation. There's another option to have an end file that is the same kind of thing, but it has everything that applies at the end of the run. One of the things that it lists are values of all the state variables that are in the math model that was used. This control at the lower right has a lot of other kinds of information about the model. Besides the echo files, we have an alphabetic listing of all the state variables, import variables, and output variables. Well, we're about done looking at the home screen. There's a lot more information installed in the help system in your software. Go to the help menu down under guides and tutorials, and you'll see that there's a quick start guide for your product. This has lots more information in it when you're getting started. Now that you've seen this, another video to view would be the one for the animator visualizer, if you haven't seen that yet, or go ahead to the video on making a simulation with a new vehicle. Thank you for watching.